Sorry, I think he is having some network failures.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So, sir, we are having, sorry, there was some issue with my microphone. I was speaking all this way along. Sir, shall we have an introduction?
Yeah, please.
Yep. Okay. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining in the What's Next, organized by IEEE Student Branch NSS College of Engineering along CGP Career Avenue. We have our honorable speaker, Mr. Ashwin P. Chandran here. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
About the speaker, Ashwin sir is a very experienced speaker who has conducted around 5,000 career webinars. He is the founder, director of Edzumo Private Limited, director of CGP Career Avenues. He trained, he served as the training and placement advisors to reputed colleges in the last 16 years. He had his first remote center, he was the first remote center coordinators of IIT Bombay in Southern Kerala in Ekalavya project. He had trained and mentored over 10,000 students in the past 15 years for competitive exams like GATE and placement trainings. He is the author of two books, Computer Peripherals and Interfacing and Crack Your Dream Job. There are still a lot to say about our speaker, Ashwin P. Sir. And I think without further delay, let's get started. Over to you, sir.
Thank you for welcoming me. So let us have a very interactive webinar. And at any point of time, you could clear your doubts. You could mute and ask or use your chat box. So before going to the webinar, I would like to know the pulse of the audience, like which all branches are here, so that talk could be focused for towards that branches. So we have students from electronics. Do we have students from electrical?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mechanical? Computer science or IT?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And civil we have? Okay. So we have students from electrical and computer science, right? Computer science or IT, right?
Sir, instrumentation too.
Yeah. Instrumentation is there. IT is there and mechanical is there, right? Or electrical, right? Electrical, isn't it?
No, sir. It's electrical, electronics, computer science and instrumentation.
Fine. Yeah. Perfectly fine. So we'll focus towards that. So, and which all semesters are here? S8 and S6 or?
S2.
We have students from S8 and S6, right?
Sir, we have students from all those branches.
All the years. Okay, fine. Okay. Now, so coming to the career opportunities, when we talk about placements, there are mainly two types of companies. Okay. There are two types of companies. One is service-based companies and second one is product-based companies. Okay. There are two types of companies, service-based companies and product-based companies. Now the service-based companies, they come for recruitment every year to reputed colleges. They conduct pool drives and recruit students in large numbers. Infosys, TCS and all come under service-based companies. Now, when we talk about product-based companies, there are companies like Mu Sigma, Directly, and some core companies also. Okay, so we'll talk about the core companies also in this webinar. So for getting into service-based companies, you should be very good in your aptitude skills, verbal, reasoning, and reasonably good in communication, that's all. Okay, you need not have an American accent or English accent to get into service-based companies. You should be confident enough to express yourself, that's all. So all these companies have aptitude tests, okay, where questions from 4th standard to 9th standard mathematics is asked plus verbal part. And those who clear may undergo a group discussion round. After that, there may be a technical HR interview or separate process and you will be given an offer letter. So many companies recruit in large number also in service-based companies. Okay. Now when it comes to product-based companies, the emphasis is more on coding skills or subject knowledge. There is a company called Directly, which used to recruit students in small numbers, okay, who are exceptionally good in coding. They pay around 12 lakhs per annum, okay, and there what they do is they give an algorithm, a problem, I mean, they give a problem, and students are asked to solve in a problem in, say, 3 hours, or maybe based on with the concepts of programming language, data structures, and algorithms. Okay, and very, very few students crack product-based companies in general compared to service-based companies, because you should be thorough in coding. There is a company called Subex. They recruit students from sixth semester onwards. Okay, not sure with the last 2 years pattern. What they do is, in the final year, they give internship to the students, where they pay a stipend to the students, and the final project could be done in the company. Okay, there also they look into a domain knowledge of how good you are in coding skills. Okay, so if you are not good in coding, it is not easy to get into product based coding based companies. Okay, in coding based product based companies, the package is higher, workload is higher, and they don't give you a lot of training. You should be really good at. Okay, but to get into service based companies, you need not be good in coding. You should be reasonably good also. If you're an IT student, for an electrical, electronics, instrumentation student, you just have to know the fundamentals of CCPP, because they give you rigorous training once you join that company. Understood? So this is the difference between service based companies and product based companies. So some students have asked me in the past, what does TCS do with electrical students, mechanical students, and all? Couple of years before, TCS used to recruit students with 8.5 GPA above or 80% and above. What they do is, these students used to have only direct interview with TCS. They don't have to undergo aptitude test or reasoning test and all. Direct interview, and if they get selected, they are into the core posting. That means electrical students will work in electrical domain, electronic students will work in electronics domain. Okay, for example, the company is developing a software for a power plant or an instrumental plant, or based on instrumentation project. So these students will provide inputs. They'll design the product and all. Like, they'll provide inputs for that. For example, if we want to develop a product or a software for some sensors and transducers based industry, then the instrumentation students will provide knowledge for that. Understand? So the coders will develop programs based on the inputs provided by the instrumentation engineers. So that is the job profile of the students in core sectors in IT. So even if you are in, you are from these branches, you can work in IT industries in this domain. Okay, even you don't like coding, and even if there are students from IT branches also who don't like coding, if there are students from circuit branches who don't like coding, there is an opportunity to work in testing, software testing, where you can work as software testers or quality analyst. Okay, quality analyst or software testers, where you test a product. Okay, you do something called manual testing, where you need not know any coding programming language. Now companies are moving towards automated testing, but again, in black box testing, you just have to test the functionality, not the code. And some testers are there who do code testing also. So without having, if they're not good in coding also, you can survive in IT industry with this product. So clear till this point now? So even if you are not good in coding, you can work in service-based companies as quality analyst, as software testers. You can work in DevOps and different domains. Is it possible to share my screen or?
Yes, sir, of course.
Right, thank you. So now coming to get job opportunities in government sectors, you can work in PSUs based on an exam called GATE. GATE stands for Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. Okay, so when we used to study, we wrote GATE exam only for purpose of getting for MTech admissions. Now people write GATE to get into PSUs. Okay, public sector undertaking. So there are a lot of PSUs recruiting students through GATE examination. Okay, then you can also do master in design in IITs. Okay, conducted in entrance exam conducted by NID, National Institute of Design. Then India Maritime University can do PG in Naval Architecture, Ocean Engineering or Marine Engineering. Okay, and you can do two types of MDuck, Teaching Assistant MDuck, which is for 2 years, offered by all IITs and NITs. And if you are working in industries and going for a sponsored project, there's a provision to do RAMDuck also, Research Assistant MDuck, where research component will be more. Understood. Majority of the people go for Teaching Assistant MDuck. Then IITs offer integrated PhD program. Okay, there is MS by Research MDuck in IITs. Master in Design is offered by all IITs and IACs, and IIT Kanpur is very dominant in that. And those students who are very passionate in physics can do integrated PhD in Indian Institute for Astrophysics. Okay, Indian Institute for Astrophysics. And many people would like to work in defense sector. Okay, so based on university entry scheme, you can apply for various posts in armed forces. Okay, and there is an opportunity to do MTech in DIAT Pune, Defense Institute for Advanced Technology Pune. Okay, based on the admission is based on GATE score. Okay, now after you are BTech, or many students may think that some students want to go for job, some students want to go for higher studies. If you want to go for higher studies, there is an opportunity called fellowship program, which is offered by IIM. Okay, IIM Calicut admits through CAT score. All other IIMs admit through GATE, CAT or JRF net score. Okay, in this fellowship program is equivalent to PhD. You are paid a monthly stipend of around 25,000 rupees. It's a 4-year program equivalent to PhD. One of the few programs where after your BTech, you can go for PhD. Okay, there's direct PhD program in IITs. Other than that, sort of the few programs which offer direct PhD program. Food and accommodation is taken care of by IIM. All your expenses, miscellaneous expenses, are also taken care of. It's an excellent opportunity, but very few people are aware about that. You can do fellowship in systems, you can do fellowship in research, you can do fellowship in marketing, you can do fellowship in HR, and so many verticals, right? NITI Mumbai also offers MTech and MBA programs, PG programs in engineering and business administration. Now, there are many students who are interested to go for management study. So fellowship program is an option. Other than that, most students prefer to go for MBA in IIMs. So admission is based on an entrance exam called CAT. It happens in November, December every year. Only 5-year students can write CAT exam. If you get very good in rank in CAT, you can study PGDM. It's equivalent to MBA, postgraduate diploma in management in IIMs. Okay, here the fees will be around 15 lakhs, but all banks will be providing loan. After completing your PGDM, you will be getting a salary of around 15 lakhs per annum. Okay, so with the first year of work itself, you can clear all your bank liabilities, and then your standard of living will be much higher because you are getting an extraordinary package from top companies in the world. Okay, so that is the beauty of studying MBA from top B schools in India. And once you prepare for CAT, you are competent to clear any aptitude exam in India, because aptitude exams, CAT is the toughest. Okay, so what do you mean by aptitude test? It's a test covering the max you studied from 4th standard to 9th standard, comprising of ratio, proportion, HCF, LCM, numbers, percentage, and all this. Okay, anyway, for placement purpose, that is for any getting into any company, you have to clear the aptitude round. For getting into banking sector, you have to clear aptitude round. And for getting 15 marks in GATE exam, you have to clear aptitude round. Okay, but for CAT, the standard of questions will be much higher compared to all other exams. Okay. Now, if a student has not decided to go for MBA, then I say GATE is a better option, because GATE score is valid for 3 years. you can have gate score in 22. With that gate score, you can apply for PSUs or go for MTech in 22, 23, and 24. There is no age limit for gate. There's no upper cutoff for gate. But for getting into PSUs, age limit matters. Understood. So if you do MTech anywhere in India, central government is paying you 12,000 rupees per month as stipend. It may be enhanced to 25,000 rupees per month as stipend in upcoming years. And after your first year, you can do a project in an R&D organization of some top companies where they may pay you 30,000 rupees per month as stipend. So that's a huge advantage for students. You will be getting somewhere like 50,000 rupees per month in your second year of MTech program. And first year, you may get between 12,000 and 25,000 rupees as stipend. And the fees will be around 2 lakhs. After completing your MTech course, your salary anywhere would be, from if it is from IITs or NITs, your salary will be around 12 lakhs to 50 lakhs per annum. Okay. So if you have not decided to go for higher studies, then you can consider GATE as a good option. Okay. But if you are passionate towards MBA, please go for it. You always have to go with your passion. Right. Now, these are the job opportunities, campus placements, government jobs, PSU jobs, railway jobs, bank IT officer for computer science branch, and different state PSC technical exams. These are the main opportunities in government sector. And these are the companies that do recruitment in small numbers in private sectors.
Sir, can you show the previous slide once more?
Infosys, TCS and all recruit in large number. Fine.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So we have computer science and IT, right? So computer science or IT students can write GATE in computer science. Okay. These are the PSUs recruiting computer science students. And though the numbers listed are less, those PSUs were listed in here are recruiting in good numbers. Okay. So one advantage for computer science students is majority of the students will stop preparing for these exams once they get offers, because the core opportunities in computer science is IT sector itself. So many students don't go for government jobs. So if you prepare reasonably well, you can crack these government jobs in computer science. So electronics and instrumentation students or electronics and communication students can write and apply for these PSUs. MDL, OML and HURL are exclusively for instrumentation branch. That is, you have to write GATE in instrumentation. And these are the PSUs recruiting electrical. So we don't have mechanical, I suppose. So I've already discussed about this. Now we'll discuss and come back to the presentation. Fine. So if an electronic student wants to get into government sector, okay, there will be around 9 to 12 opportunities every year. Okay, BARC, ISRO, and many PSUs are recruiting students in large number every year. Okay, so for that, you have to write an exam called GATE. Okay, there will be 65 questions in GATE, and GATE score is valid for 3 years. Apart from GATE, you can write exam conducted by BARC, you can write exam conducted by DRDO, you can write exam conducted by Airport Authority of India. You can write exam conducted by BSNL, JE, like SSC JE and Railway JE. Okay. So if you study 10 subjects thoroughly, you can crack any job in government sector in electronics or instrumentation. Okay. That is analog, circuits, digital, networks, controls. These subjects are common for electronics and instrumentation branch. For getting into ISRO, you have to study the electronic subjects like SSD, communication, electromagnetic theory and signals. Okay, you have to study these subjects for getting into gate in, PSUs based on electronics gate, or if you want to crack ISRO exams. For ISRO exams, you have to study optics and microwave in addition to the above mentioned subjects. Okay, you have to study optics and microwave in addition to the above mentioned subjects. Right, now for writing gate in instrumentation, instead of SSD, you can write measurements. Okay, you can write measurements, also sensors and transducers. You don't have to study EMT and SSD for gating instrumentation. Okay, but for ISRO exam, this is based on electronics and communication syllabus. Now from 21, the beauty is students can write gate in communication as well as in instrumentation. Instrumentation students can write in communication and instrumentation, same for communication students also. So if you want to focus into PSUs, majority of the PSUs are recruiting based on gate in EC communication. Some PSUs are recruiting based on instrumentation also, but competition is relatively less based on instrumentation syllabus. But for ISRO, syllabus is based on communication. Same with BSNL, DRDO, and other PSUs. So this is how you have to prepare for these government exams in electronics. Okay, you can also write gate in physics. And okay, so electronic students can write gate in physics and instrumentation. Instrumentation students can write gate in electronics and physics. Understood. And there are some companies like Tata and Lexi, okay, recruiting students, okay, based on your project work. Some companies like Winwish Technologies in Technopark, they're absorbing students from instrumentation and communication branch as analog circuit designer. Okay, as analog circuit designer. There is a company called Light Logics which absorbs students from physics and electronics instrumentation stream as engineers working with optics area. Okay, light and optics area. Okay, and Quest and Cubers are also recruiting students for signal processing and image processing domains, right? So these are the opportunities for electronic students. Now for computer science and IT students, you can write, you have to study 10 subjects thoroughly, and they are digital, data structures, computer organization, operating system, DBMS, networks, theory of computation, compilers, and algorithms. Okay, for ISRO exams, you have to study software engineering in addition to the above mentioned subjects. There are a lot of PSUs recruiting computer science students. There are many state PSUs also conducting exams like lecture in polytechnic, where eligibility is beta. You don't have to have M.Tech degree. Okay, same with Kendriya Vidyalaya lectures. Okay, all this exam is almost on same pattern. For some exams, you don't need not stress on TOC compilers and all. Instead, you have to study OOPS and Java, maybe client server architecture, and maybe like graphics and all. But core syllabus 90% is same as that of GATE. Understood. So this is how you can get into a job in government sector in computer science, the government, okay, or information technology. Now all railways and all banks are moving, having lot of offerings in IT sector. So if you prepare well in these subjects, there's always a good chance to crack job in government sector, government recruitment boards in computer science or IT. Now coming to electrical, you have to study analog, signals, digital, networks, and a little bit of EMT controls. Then big three subjects: power system, power electronics, machines. Okay, power system, power electronics and machines, and also measurements. Electrical students can write gate in instrumentation also. In that case, you don't have to study power system, power electronics and machines, but you have to study transducers and some modules of communication. Understood. There are a lot of PSUs recruiting students for electrical also. Okay, now There are some companies which are offering internship for electrical. Tata Elxsi is offering internship based on your work in electric vehicle design areas. Okay. And there are some other companies also, Winwish Technologies, which I've mentioned, are also recruiting students from electrical domain as unlocked circuit designers. Okay, same with Quest Global and Qburst. Chema Power Infrastructure, Wipro Infrastructure are also recruiting students from electrical domain. Okay, but majority of the recruitments in electrical happens in public sector or in government sector. Private companies recruiting electrical are relatively less in number. Any doubts till this point?
Sir, what is the scope for electrical students in ISRO?
Now, to be very honest with you, the opportunities for electrical in ISRO are relatively less compared to EC, computer science and mechanical. Okay, but there are openings, but not in large number. Okay, the syllabus that I have mentioned is same for ISRO. In addition to the above mentioned subject, you have to study dielectric materials also. Now, Baba Atomic Research Center. BARC recruits students through GATE. Other than GATE, they also conduct their own exam. If there are 200 openings, 100 openings are through GATE and 100 openings are through their own exam they conduct every year, which is same as that of GATE. DRD also conducts an exam same as that of GATE. So the beauty is, if you study the 10 subjects thoroughly, you can either crack GATE or get into any of these PSUs through their own exam. Okay, so on average you'll be getting 9 opportunities every year. If you're lucky, you get up to 12 to 15 opportunities also. So only one thing, power system is power system for all exams, isn't it? It is same for ISRO, same for GATE or BARC or DRD or whatever be. So you should study these subjects thoroughly to get into government sectors. That's all. Any doubts? Any further doubts? Now, Air Traffic Airport Authority of India conducts an examination for the post of air traffic controller. Okay, here the syllabus is not, I mean, it was through GATE. Now it is through an exam they conduct in every 2 years, where your, I mean, the examination is based on 11th standard and 12th standard physics and maths, in addition to aptitude and general knowledge. Right now, so many students have asked me, can we do preparations on our own? It is very much possible. You can prepare on your own also. But if there's a structured coaching system where high profile faculty members or a pool of faculty members are there to support you, it'd be much easier to crack these exams. Understood? So CGP, our organization, CGP stands for Center for GATE and Placements. Two unique things that we have brought to table is, first thing, before a student joins, we'll be sharing the list of faculty members who are going to engage them and their qualifications. Students must know where they have undergone their PGs and what was their GATE rank. Second thing, we share the videos of the previous classes they have conducted last year, so students will know the quality of the class. So minimum class duration is 350 hours, okay, minimum. And once a student joins our scheme of things, they can study without any additional fees till they get into ISRO or GATE or PSU. Okay, they can study without any additional fees till they get into ISRO, BARC or PSU. So we provide a stress-free coaching environment. Students will be getting complete books, 14 to 16 books, plus sectional test, topic test and all India mock test, placement training with one-to-one mock interview by reputed HRs with feedback. Interview training is also incorporated. Okay, recorded videos and live classes. Even a student misses a live class, recorded videos are made available. More than that, corporate sponsorship scheme for financially weak students. Okay, so I don't know any other establishment supports students to this much extent. Anyway, we do, and we'll be happy to support any student who is interested to undergo. And for the S6 students, my humble request is whatever, wherever you go for preparations, or if you do on your own also, take GATE 22 very seriously. Okay, so you try your level best to crack GATE 22 exam, because before you leave the campus, you should have a good GATE score. And in 6 months from 2022 June, you can get into a PSU or a government establishment with your GATE 22 score. For S4 students, you can write GATE in 22, you can write GATE in 23. The biggest advantage of GATE 22 is you don't have any tension. Okay, and GATE 22 can be used as a launching pad for GATE 23 also, right? In what we do, CGP does is, for S4 students, we'll be teaching subjects in S4 that are relevant for GATE. So this helps in university exams also. For IT, we teach them OS, DBMS and all, which are relevant to the university syllabus also. For electronic students, we teach like analog circuits or SSD or EMD, which are relevant to that semester. So it helps a lot in university examinations also. Same thing happens in S5, same thing happens in S6. For S8 students, what we request is you try to immediately undergo a program after a university exam. You prepare for 2 months intensively, because ISRO exams may happen in August, September. Okay, so after university exam, if you dedicate 2 months fully, you can perform well in ISRO exam. And most of the PSU exams may happen before October 2021. Okay, so you can study in such a way that you can, if even the company where you get selected ask you to join, the preparations till that point of time will help you to prepare for the PSUs on Saturdays and Sundays, or just revise after you join the companies. Okay, so take your time very seriously, because for all PSUs there's an age limit. For MTech there is no age limit, for PSU there is age limit. So based on that, the higher the chances would be if you clear these exams in 2022 or maximum 2022 for final year students. Okay, for pre-final year students, earlier the better. You can crack GATE in 22, okay, and get into PSUs. What CGP does is, we do is, we teach first for GATE, next GATE exam, and after the GATE exam, the batch migrates to ISRO batch, where all the questions for ISRO exams are discussed, then goes to BARC batch and all. So classes continue till the students get into ISRO PSU. Fine. So now let us now have an open discussion on any queries on your career or any doubts on higher studies. And after this webinar also, if you have any doubt regarding our program or any doubt regarding your career, you can be free to ask. It doesn't matter, like even if you join us or not, doesn't matter. Any doubts on your career, we'll be more than happy to help you out. I also request you to fill the feedback form so that we will know where all we can improve upon. Any doubts? Any doubts?
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, please.
Yeah, first of all, thank you for your session. It was a wonderful session. So what I have a doubt is, so how much time should we spend for getting a better placement? Like how, and how much depth should we have in technical and verbal and aptitude?
So you're looking about placements in private companies, or are you looking for placements in government, I mean core government sectors?
And private companies.
Once again?
Private companies.
So if you, that is, if you want to look into private companies, you just have to practice well in aptitude questions. Okay. You can set, I mean, there are a lot of platforms available for practicing. You have to plan maybe like every month. Which semester you're studying now?
So I'm currently doing my S6 semester.
You'll be attending placement process by July. Okay, yeah. By June, July.
Yeah, okay, sir.
So if you dedicate 10 hours per month, it'll be more than enough.
Okay, sir.
Thank and you me. Should be good. Which branch you are from?
I'm from computer science.
Okay, very good. So in the sense, you can practice the questions are also on technical aptitude exams also, like C, because many questions from technical aptitude are also asked, like swap two numbers without third variable using a single operator. Questions from that area also ask for exam. So you should practice on aptitude, verbal, reasoning, and technical aptitude, mostly based on C programming.
Okay, sir.
Fine.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So what about the internship opportunities for triple students abroad?
For internships for triple students, there are two options. First thing is, if you have which semester you are studying, Rajesh?
I'm in currently in S4.
S4, excellent. So ideal thing is, if you have a good GATE score in S6 in 2022, all the companies like Tata Powers and PSUs and any companies in LTK will be happy to provide you internship with stipend. Other than that, based on your project work also, you can apply for internships. If you have done a project on for a public domain, for a public cause, okay. And if you have a good project idea, then many companies, if you mail to the HRs and CEOs, they'll be glad to provide you internship. When I say internship, it is not that where we pay the money, we should get stipend. Sometimes we may not get stipend, but there's no paying money to any company for internship. It's not internship. Internship is something where you get stipend, you contribute to the company. So it could be based on your GATE score or based on a unique idea or based on your project. So as I mentioned, if you do projects on electric vehicle designs and all, there are a lot of companies providing internship nowadays. You can also apply through Idathons and Hackathons. Fine.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Next question. So, see, in our case, in our GATE program for computer science and IT is on Saturday, Sundays, 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. And those students who miss them can access as recorded video. And students study till they get IIT or ISR without additional fees. For electronics, electrical, instrumentation students, live classes are on Wednesdays and Fridays. And even they miss, for any class, if the students miss, they can attend on at their convenience also. There'll be weekly tests and placement training program on aptitude, verbal, GD interview, mock interview and all happens on Sundays, 4:30 p.m. For GATE students, it is made free. Students can join for placement training alone. There's a special scheme for class toppers or students with 8.5 GPA and above. And there are students who are interested. They can attend scholarship examination and get scholarships. And financially deserving students are provided additional scholarship by our alumni who have been working in reputed organizations. So there are a lot of schemes to support different group of students. And coming to IITs also offer summer and winter internship programs. You can apply for that also. Now it is in online mode. Okay. And there are many IT companies providing internships for electrical students in areas like data science for electrical. Okay. Data science for electrical. So you can do data science projects also based on R programming language. Need not be on Python, can be on R programming, which is more useful for students who don't like coding. It is based on statistic modeling and probabilities. Fine. Any other doubts? Now, when it comes to instrumentation projects, okay, it depends upon the project work that we do and the scope of the project. One thing is there, majority of the instrumentation companies are outside Kerala to an extent outside India. Okay, but there are a lot of opportunities also in Middle East and other countries. So getting opportunity for virtual internship in electrical domain and instrumentation domain is relatively difficult. Okay, because you have to spend at least 6 months for that. Okay, you have to spend at least 6 months for that. But you can do instrumentation in optics domain, optics and instrumentation angle you can do. Optical communication you can do, which comes more under instrumentation. And many healthcare units are also providing internships, like for every healthcare unit we know, for ECG machines and all, lot of applications of instrumentation happens. In that sector, students can do projects. Okay, so I think even DRD also supports that. But it is not based on academy projects, but it is based on a unique ideas or concepts or mini projects you do. Of course, you can do ISR also. I represent an organization called ACM. ACM stands for Association for Computing Machinery, like IEEE for you people, electronics and electrical. ACM conducts some hands-on courses on data science, machine learning, and ACM is being a professional body, not a profit-making organization. We do virtually free for students. Okay, only 100 rupees and all are charged by the students, just to make it serious. Okay. So we do a lot of programs on data science on regular basis on online mode. Sometimes students get opportunity to internship also. Okay. And tomorrow, CGP, our organization, is doing a program called Interview Mastery. It is on tomorrow and Thursday and Friday, 7 to 9 p.m., where top 4 industry experts, HRs, will be training students on how to prepare your unique resume, how to prepare for GD interview and all. And students from our collaborating colleges have to pay only 100 rupees. Okay, if you WhatsApp me, I can share the details on that too. Okay, so short-term courses means don't go for any CAT type of soft-mean courses immediately, because short-term courses means you need not do paid courses. You can do some free courses. There are a lot of free platform courses available in many platforms. You can undergo from NPTEL and all. Yeah. Now, when it comes to defense sector, okay, of course, your prior knowledge in data sciences or security, cyber security is very useful. But when you get into defense sector, they will be training you intensively on their requirements. Okay. So if a student gets into any DRDO through GATE or any other exam, then they'll be training you in different verticals and place you in different jobs, including cybersecurity. A small certification in cybersecurity may not be helpful to get into defense sector, but you can work in IT industries based on certifications. Okay. Now, some IEEE is also, I guess, starting a code program in cybersecurity. You can really go for that. Okay. So, but in the defense sector, private certifications may not be helpful. Once you are selected, they will train intensively, and you may be trained in different areas. Okay, it is not that you can get into cybersecurity based on a certification. Distance education is never equivalent to regular courses. If you do distance MBA or MTech, you may not be getting jobs in government sectors that easily, because even though it is approved by some state universities, it's not nationally approved. So it is always good to do PG in IITs or NITs or IIM or top institutions in India. Regular studies is much better than part-time. Okay, but you can do part-time programs. Okay, but the difference between part-time and distance education, part-time is a program that we do on evenings or sometimes on these many hours on Saturday, Sundays and all. Distance learning is of course, IGNOS MBA and all approved, but many companies, for example, Infosys, what HRs used to say, tell me, is that they prefer students who do direct PG program, not distance education program. Okay. Certifications are good for distance education, but not for this thing. So it's always good if you do regular program. For example, if a student is good in, say, Vastu, you can do a distance course on Vastu, on numerology, or like psychology, if you are interested, you can do on psychology. Okay. But for engineering related, it is very difficult to convince interview boards after your distance course. Even management to an extent is possible, but top companies prefer regular course. It's a good question. Any other questions? So assuming that you don't have any other doubts, we can wind up. I once again repeat, if you have any doubts, you can WhatsApp me or call me anytime. We'll be more than happy to help you. So thank you for patient listening and very good interactions. Okay, so I wish you all the very best wishes. Study well, take your project and classwork very seriously. May God bless you all. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Ashwin sir, for the wonderful webinar. It was really an informative one, and I hope that will guide many students right here, and many students in our contacts too, many of our friends, our colleagues in their future.
Thank you.
Yeah, once again, I thank you on from my side and also from my organization. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thanks a lot. So all the best wishes.
Thank you, sir.